Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. If you've been keeping up with this video series, you know that we've already taken off the heads on our 2004 Yamaha F225. Now, it's time to turn our attention to the bottom end. There are no special tools or parts that are going to be required or that we use in this video. So if you're ready, let's go ahead and jump straight into it. We're going to start on this side by getting this cooling cover. I'm going to spin it around. And then we'll start taking off the crankcase cover as well as the crankcase, the lower half of the crankcase assembly. At that point, we start pulling these pistons out. Once again, these are numbered in a sequence. If you were actually installing it, we're doing the opposite. So we want to find the highest number and work our way down. And it looks like 13 is the highest. Couple of different pry points. There we go. Now, let's go ahead and get our filter housing out of the way. Next, let's go ahead and get our oil fill and our linkages removed. So we have 17 total, so we're going to start right there, work our way back. Let's go. Now let's go ahead and bring off this windage tray. All right, guys, what we're going to be doing here is just breaking the bolts loose on the connector rod caps. Go ahead and remove the cap. Make sure you grab the bearing because it's going to have a color on it. At that point, we're just going to take a long extension and reach all the way up to the base of the piston and go ahead and pop it out of the bore. Just make sure you've got your hand on the other side to actually catch it so it doesn't dump out onto the floor. Hey, we're going to do this, guys. Just take this long extension, go all the way to the bottom of the piston and pop it. Yeah, you can tell when the motor stopped and sat for obviously a long time. You can see where each piston was because you can feel in there and actually feel where it's rusting. And there's actually a hump at each location. So all the way down, this one's about mid, almost two-thirds of the way up. This one's about right here. Same thing on this side. Here, here, and then down at the bottom. So this engine sat for a long time. And what has actually happened to it, we can't see it without cutting it apart. On the exhaust down at the bottom, it is eaten so far, it has actually gone into one of the oil passages. And that's why when you tried to fill it up with oil and we were cranking it over doing the compression and the leak down test, oil was actually dumping straight into the exhaust. So this block is trashed. I think we're going to be able to reuse the crank. We're going to pull that in a minute to make sure it's okay. Connecting rods look okay. I'm not going to reuse the pistons, so we'll be replacing those as well as the rings. And then we'll end up just building it all from scratch. On every other section of the engine, they give you the sequence to either install or remove all the bolts, except for this one. But I'm going to mark how to do it. But basically, it starts with these outside bolts, and you're just running back and forth, working your way in. And then you do basically the same thing to get your mains loosened up. So I'm going to grab a pen and go ahead and mark these just for fun so you can keep up with it. Number one, two, three, down here, four, five, 6 and 7 down here. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. That should be all of them around the outside perimeter. Now I'm going to buzz them out using the impact now that they're broken loose. So, we've got our 13 millimeter. Let's keep going. 15. 16. 18. 19. 20. 21. Where's 22? 23. 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, Okay guys, so basically we're going to leave it in the stand. We're going to go ahead and separate the lower half of the crankcase from the upper half, and we're going to leave the oil pump in place, and that'll keep the crankshaft from actually falling out. And once we finish separating the lower and upper half of the crankcase itself, then we can lay it over on a table. I can take off the engine stand and then remove the oil pump. All right guys, let's go ahead and get the oil pump off. Then we should be able to just lift out the crank, and we're pretty much done breaking this one down. There we go. Oh, making a mess. Now, all right guys, she's broken down all the way, and what I did is I removed this cap that exposes one of the oil galleyways, and I want to show you now what killed this block. Corrosion has eaten it up to the point in the exhaust that it ate up into that galleyway. And what I'm going to do is just shine a flashlight from up above, and then with the other camera, you can see light coming through. So that level of corrosion has destroyed this block, and there's no way to fix it. So where does that leave us now? What's going to happen next? I'm going to go order a bunch of parts, and then we're going to start methodically putting this entire engine back together. I will try to use as many of the old parts as possible and only replace what is absolutely necessary. At this point, I believe that we can get away with just doing the block itself, as well as pistons and rings, and of course new bearings. Well, all right guys, I'm about to head back to my office and order a bunch of parts for this project. Well, listen, and speaking of parts, if you need any for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you like what you see and you want to see me finish this out, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Have a great day.